Now, and delegates of the New Patriotic Party in the Manhia North constituency of the Ashanti region are voting to elect a parliamentary candidate in what is expected to be a keenly contested primaries. Now, issues surrounding the constituency album have delayed primaries over a year. We'll be joining William Evans Inkum for some live update.
To elect somebody to lead the party in Manhia North, complement the full set of parliamentary candidates who representing the NPP at the constituency level. Analysis here. Now, in 2012 elections, we are looking at the parliamentary results as far as Manhia North is concerned. Collins Owusu Amankwa, who is the incumbent MP, stood for on the ticket of the NPP and he had 36,775. Samuel Bofa Donko, the NDC candidate, had 139. Justice Ikwe Ofori, the NDP candidate, had 2,342. Richard Akwa, the PPP candidate, had 306. Total vote cast was 52,862. Now let's do a bit of analysis here. That is very interesting because if you look at the presidential results, there were some major political parties are concerned, the presidential candidates of the two parties leverage their performance. And to make sense of that, let's just look at the presidential results in 2012. Now, John Dramani Mahama, the NDC presidential candidate, had 14,890 votes. And Nana Adodankwa Akufo-Addo, the NPP presidential candidate, had 37,853. Now, this is where the interesting part is. If you look at the vote of Nana Adodankwa Akufo-Addo, he's sweeping 37,853. Let's compare it to the candidate, Collins Owusu Amankwa of the NPP. He had 36,775. So we are talking about a difference of 1,000 approximately being appreciated. That is on the part of the NPP presidential candidate. If you look at the NDC presidential candidate in the person of John Dramani Mahama, he had 14,000 votes against the parliamentary candidate Samuel Bofa Donko, who also gathered 13,000. So he also appreciated his vote by 1,000 approximately in 2012 elections. But this afternoon, we've seen 495 delegates who are casting their vote to get somebody to represent the NPP as far as the Manhia North constituency is concerned. I've been joined by Stephen Amwa, a member of the executive Ashanti Region executives of the NPP. So, Stephen, I think the most important thing is ensuring a unified body as far as the Ashanti Regional NPP is concerned, for that matter, Manhia North constituency, because there has been a lot of litigation.
Thank you. I really agree to your point that the most important factor is having the needed cohesion, unity that we need to put up a front to make sure that the MPP can wrestle far from the NDC. But of course, what you see here is an empirical evidence to show that all stakeholders have been spoken to. We try to make sure that the conflict has been put behind us and forge forward as a party. I am inundated with reports from all factions within this, you know, fraternity. I mean, so far as Manhia North is concerned. And all of them are saying that so far they're happy with the processes and then the proceedings that are actually prevailing here. So I think we've done a lot. We've been talking to their various supporters. We've been talking to all stakeholders within the constituencies. We've been talking to the aspirants. We've been talking to the polling station agents. And I think so far, so good. I mean, you can see that there seem to be the needed tranquility and cohesion for this exercise. And you see what is happening here.
All right. So we will be speaking to Daniel Losea Janim, who is a member of the committee set up to oversee this very primaries. But as the election exercises ongoing. The electoral officers from the electoral commission, officials from the electoral commission, have taken a position ensuring that the exercise actually goes on in a peaceful and or a smooth manner. All the delegates are standing outside, and when your name or your polling station is mentioned, then you come in and vote. Security is also very tight. Well, the Delta Force security is complementing the efforts of the police, who have been detailed at vantage positions to ensure law and order. So, Steka, before we even speak to Daniel, now, you have been speaking to the candidates. We have three candidates at the moment. Have they given you the word that whatever may be the case, they will still rally behind the party?
I think that is what I said at first. We've tried so hard to engage all of them, and so far, the signals that I'm having from them, the reports I'm having from them, indicate that they are all happy with what is happening. But of course, I will still try to use your medium as a platform to actually talk to all stakeholders, to eschew all forms of antisocial behaviors that probably might have the potential to jeopardize the peaceful processes that we are all experiencing today. So I think the key stakeholders, i.e. the aspirants, right now I spoke with them. Finally, to find out whether they are okay. And each of them said he is fine with what is happening so far. So it is my prayer that this thing will continue to happen, so that we come to a very peaceful, successful end. At the end of it all, the needed cohesion that we need in Manhia North will be actually grabbed to enable us as a region secure the minimum of 80% vote that we are looking for. Right. So I'll tell each and every one here to see this as in-house game. Right. Whichever way it goes, I will just admonish each and every one to actually accept defeat or success. Those who win should manage it in a way that other people will not actually come in to do any other thing that would jeopardize the peaceful processes. Right. And those who lose should take it in good faith and join us.
All right. Well, let me speak to Daniel. Daniel, you have been working so hard to ensure that this particular exercise comes to fruition. Now, the last time I spoke to you, four polling stations had their elections withheld. Are they taking part in this particular exercise?
No, they are not.
And would that not undermine the very progress you are making?
No, not at all. We've informed the parties involved. I'm talking about the candidates. And as usual, per our constitution, we need a certain number of percentage. That is about 90% of the total delegates. If we have 90% of them, then we can go on with any elections. And I believe that we have more than 90% of the delegates now, so therefore we can go on with any elections. For instance, if we should go in for a congress now across the nation, of course you will not have full 100% of the delegates in each and every constituency album, because some that have died, some that have traveled and other stuff. So as much as we have more than 90%, then you can go on with any elections.
All right, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right. So we have been speaking to Danny and Steka, who have been telling us and also giving assurances to their supporters out there that everything has been put in place to ensure that there is peaceful coexistence within the rank and file of the NPP party as far as the Ashanti region is concerned. So as I indicated to you early on, we have 495 delegates who will be voting to elect among the three in a manner that has been arranged on the ballot paper. We have Colin Sowusu Amankwa, the incumbent, leading the pace. We have Frank Osei Banfo and also Yao Konedu, who are all eyeing to get that single nod for Parliament, hopefully in November, during the November polls. My name is William Evansinkum, and you can still log on to our website, www.3news.com, or tune in to 87.9 Akoma FM for more updates on the Manhia primaries. Over to you, Wendy.
William Evansinkum from the Ashanti region.